they live the same or no?
They make fungus.
They make fungus?
They eat the fungus.
Mm. And that's what they eat.
That's rock.
It's so cute. Like they're sharing little green flags.
Here. Mm-hmm. Poisonous. Mm-hmm. Poisonous rock is. Made it?
And they make, see, he's gonna make that noise with the belly. See the belly?
Mm-hmm.
Vibration. Mm-hmm. It's the male.
Is it poison?
Yes, poison. Mm-hmm.
Garbage, but they have sharp teeth, long tail.
It's hard to see it. It looks like a hummingbird, but it's not a hummingbird.
So this is the other species of iguana. We call it green iguana. No matter if they're orange, they still green iguana.
Because they're only green when they're babies.
So for butterflies.
Oh,
yeah, the little Inca dog.
Inca dog.
Over in the water.
So they create friction, and that friction is able to help them to run on the two back legs. So their nickname is related to what they do. Oh, jeez! But the real name is brown basilisk, which is one of the three species of basilisk or Jesus Christ lizard we have. Now, this is smart enough to know that between tides, high and low tide, he got there, and there's going to be food. Crayfish, all basic stuff. So that's very important. Now, the second thing is important, this runs to the ocean, so when the ocean water changes the direction, it becomes brackish. So the tidal changes. So how much it could vary? From 6 to almost 18 feet. Now you know why the root systems are like that.
Three different things.
Chimpanzee, yeah, open body, and then on the tail too. So they look like a dinosaur. They pretend to be like a dinosaur. See? What is
that
there?
Oh, look.
The female, or young one, tried to approach, so he's trying to push him out of his territory. So like all the reptiles, they're definitely territory. There's two of them right there. A young one and a old one. The second creature with less changes in evolution.
Yeah,
used to be my mother-in-law.
So if you really want to become a professional, want to earn a gold medal. Good spot. Now let me ask you, how many people from Costa Rica have you seen earning a gold medal?
Now,
it's not even worrying, not because we're all really feeding. But right now, his concern is son, somebody. And then you can actually see the tip of one of their teeth that ate across all the way to the upper jaw. Some teenagers, kindergarten. There, but okay, this is my point. They will hardly have something in between crocodiles and water access, but they're so smart, and they're going to take advantage of us being so close to common people. So the show is not about us. The show is about their needs to get to reach the water without turning themselves into bait. Okay? But that tells you how smart they are. So they're not here, and their interest is not to... Part of the social behavior is that they help each other to get clean up. Those are one of the most hard to find creatures because they're vegan. They travel so much in one day. If you're able to get a good picture, you can tell them.
Amazon kingfisher. American pygmy. Amazon kingfisher. Ring kingfisher. Ring anillo. Great neck wood whale. There it is. I might sink in the mud. This is the other species of flycatcher. Smaller. Smaller. Right in this little palm tree. A sandpiper. It's hard to believe that a crocodile, which has mean reputation, big teeth, 3,800 pounds of pressure. They do need this bird to clean up their teeth.
Oh, yeah?
Nature taking care of nature. So these bats, we call it long nose bats. They average 2,000 mosquitoes a night. Not during the day. So that helps us to get rid of a problem. And although this is not the time where you see a lot of mosquitoes, because there's no standing water, it's warm enough.
Not enough for people.
See? You see it over there?
Yeah, you can grab it.
That tells you more than itself. So how did the crocodile get up there? Well, it waited until the tide was high enough. Say it's somewhere around here. So then they climb up there. So stay away from hurting their eyes with salt water. They're freshwater frogs. Okay, now let me go back. Have you heard the expression crocodile tears? That's where the expression came from. Turtles, crocodiles, and certain creatures, since we do not tolerate salt in our eyeballs, we create tears to remove the salt. That's where the expression crocodile tears came from. So they try to blend in. They're not like chameleons, they don't change color. But everything official, they gotta make adjustments just like the bird. The bird looks almost like a stick. They can get really close to whatever. The crocodile, they only have their eye movement on the propeller in the water, which is a warning for them. But they don't know what kind of thing is coming to approach to him, and he doesn't know what size it is. So guess what? They're smart enough to just go away.
think he's hurt.
Thank you.
Do what?
they have a good eye to see all that.
Without the stem, that the same stem is inside of the pipes. The green pipe we see on the side of the road,
being like the water boiling.
Eating just fruits with a monkey does, you're never going to expect to see that monkey much walking on the ground. When they make balance, it's branch to branch.
More front.
Yeah. guy goes.
You see him?
Oh yes, sorry. It's been dense, so sorry, my fault. I don't know.
Just look, straight ahead, just look at the clouds.
There'll be 600 to 1,000 degrees temperature.
Show the spiny stems.
Oh yes.
So they protect them. They protect themselves.
Yeah.
It's actually a whole ecosystem. So it homes different plants and trees going on.
Very quickly. Thank you.
to the Métis. If you smoke it, you never come back, maybe. It fries your brain.
Looking straight at us. It's even nearer now. It's posing now.
raccoon and coatis are related. They are no. This guy is omnivorous. Omnivorous means they eat anything. They have a pretty long nose. That nose means they have a really good smell sense. They eat anything. Omnivorous. Yeah, Mexico and South America, their coatis are a little different compared with us, with our coatis, because just the color. Over there, sometimes it looks like reddish or light brown.
Yes.
This one is more like a black.
Yes.
The male is solitary. They never travel in troops. They're always alone. So when you see like a lot of this, that's for females and baby ones or young ones. Those one, if people are annoying, of course. In some places, people feed them. That's why they look like so.
These are the ones Costa Rica.
That's what they look like.
Let's come over to us. He knows where the big tips are.
That's
what's the name?
It's a duck.
Oh, okay.
You have some North American?
They make low migration for North America. That is known as the tiger heron. That's the species. The bear trail is tiger heron. Large birds like that are what they make mama's crocodiles to be very aggressive. A baby crocodile is about the size of your hands. This is a baby. When you see some small crocodile, they're going to be more like a teenager, because that lizard is able to walk in the water. So we get in close to them. Possible as a little blue area. That's a little blue area.
So to my right, it's behind me, so I think so. That wouldn't help because he's beyond a twig and that's where his eye focus.
Right. Why doesn't
it? I'm trying to focus on him manually, see if that helps.